So I showed up at I was 19 years old, and I had moved into the dorms, and it was a must-take situation where to be in the dorms, you had to be a full-time student, and I had missed the other drawing or painting class that had been filled up. So they told me, one of the advisors said, "You know what, Diego? Why don't you just try this? I really think you'll click with this teacher. Her name's Adelaide Loloma. She's a Hopi woman." Of course, I took the class, and out of that, a beautiful relationship was born. I learned so much from Adelaide, and quickly, pottery and traditional pottery and Pueblo pottery became my passion. And I just devoured this stuff. And I actually, for a while, kind of forgot about the comics and the illustration and became totally consumed with making the pots and the traditional vessels and forms and the burnish. It wasn't until later in grad school that the comics re-enter into the pottery, and that becomes becomes a combination of my childhood and my early youth. So Loloma was an incredible influence on me, and showed me again the possibilities in pottery. Loloma also was very traditional, but also very contemporary at the same time. So I was lucky enough to come across this person at an early stage in my life, and she fueled my passion and my desire to make Pueblo pottery. It also became the most Indian part of me at one point in my life, because I was not born and raised in New Mexico, and I was not born and raised in Cochiti Pueblo. So I guess a lot of me identified with my Indian self through Pueblo pottery at this point in my life. I did know that I wanted to go to grad school. There were options beyond the institute at that time. They were in the business of giving you a 2-year AFA and sending you off to another place. I wound up at first Otis Parsons, where I studied under Ralph Becerra, who was a major influence in my life. You could come to Ralph and ask him anything, and he would show you how to do it. Or if he didn't know how, he would be honest with you and help you figure it out. And I knew when I did later teach, I wanted to be that type of teacher. After that, I wound up with Adrian at UCLA. I'm gonna say Adrian pushed me into the direction where I wound up today. Right off the bat, Adrian wanted art to be of intellect. It had to have an intellectual basis. It had to provoke conversation. It had to be thought-provoking. There had to be a narrative. Before this, I was actually more of a traditional potter and someone that had studied design. And when I wound up with Adrian, it kind of threw me for a loop, because he did push me into making the art I do today, the narrative. And I developed the Mimbrus style that came out of it, which has now blossomed into something even larger, I would say. I would say it is in the blood. It's my blood memory that brought me here. Raised my children here. The other day, I was walking by the bank of the river with my daughter, and I thought to myself, I've had an ancestor that's walked along this riverbank for the last several, at least 1,000 years by now. There's been a part of me, a direct ancestor of a piece of me that was connected directly to this place, this mountain, this spot. So I do feel I am here where I'm supposed to be, that this is the time and place and space that I'm supposed to be. I feel like all these people throughout time have come together so I can do this and create the narrative that I've been so privileged to allow to do, that the creator and the people, the collectors and the museums all appreciate it. And I just want to say I never thought it would go here. I only just wanted to make a living at this from the very beginning. I'm very grateful for what it's provided me in my life. I just want to make art now. I just that's how I feel, is that this has done so much for me that I have to return and make the art and do the art, and, you know, as a way of gratitude for my place in the universe.